some of our best sketches of the season, but first up, we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to be just loosening up, we're just going to be warming up with an improv game we call Freeze Tag. So all we need to get started is a suggestion of any kind from the audience, please.
Cowboy.
I made your favorite, Randy, enchiladas.
Oh, it's good being a Mexican these days.
Oh, you shut your fucking mouth right now.
Please! I made you lemonade, why don't you come over and drink it? Huh?
Well, because you've got a rare disease.
Well,
freeze.
Is it the fire alarm?
Oh, shit. Everybody get out, guys. Everybody get out.
Frozen improviser here.
Should we unfreeze her?
Oh, no, that's dangerous. You don't know what scene she was in.
Maybe we should just go take her down to the magnet dumpster.
Yeah, just forget about it. Someone's bound to unfreeze us sooner or later. Let's just get out of here.
Future freeze tag, but first we need a future suggestion.
Gleep Gore!
I heard Gleep Gore!
Dirty mind.
I made your favorite man, Gleep Gore!
You're too good to me, Romulus 4000.
You shut your fucking mouth right now.
Freeze!
Oh, thank God.
What is God?
My name's Catherine. I'm an improviser from the 21st century. Thank you so much for unfreezing me. If you could just teach me how to play freeze tag in your century, I would really appreciate
freeze.
It.
Freeze! Just needed to shut her up.
She wouldn't stop. Oh, my God.
Sure, Yasmin? You know what happened last time.
I'll be fine, I promise. Pinky swear. Please have a seat, sir.
Thanks.
Before I take it from you.
Okay.
My name's Yasmin. It means fragrant flower.
Oh, nice.
So you're here to open a bank account. I'm assuming not a joint account.
No, I'm the sole account holder.
Isn't it crazy how a woman has to wear the engagement ring, but the man doesn't?
Yeah.
Your name, please?
It's Leon Kandinsky.
Leon, as in lion. Don't maul me! I still got a church. I got to go to church on Sunday, huh? What's today's date?
September.
It's been so long since I've been on a date. Get it together, Yasmin!
I have my ID here. I assume you need to photocopy it. I can just fill this out, you know, just to save us time.
Don't worry. It's my job to figure out what you need, and for me to fulfill that need.
Okay.
Get it together, girlfriend! Who loves you?
Oh, I brought this check. I want to deposit.
Great. Well, how about I give you my card? No, wait. Okay. How about I call you? No, wait. How about I give you my phone number in the back of this card? And
okay.
The ink is run out of this pen. So, where's... Oh, yeah. Keep that. Keep this. Courtesy of Flushing Savings Bank. Thank you for coming. And if someone is going to call somebody.
Okay.
About
my account?
But everything! I am an attractive, church-going woman. There are no single men at my church. This is really hard for me.
Yes, I'll take it from here.
We take it really slow. Like we can have coffee. We have a Keurig machine right here. Look, you can pick a K cup. We've got some dark magic. We've got some hazelnut.
Okay.
One's a light roast. The other's a dark roast.
Okay. Oh. Excuse me, I have to take this. Sorry.
No, please do.
Just
I'll
give me
here.
Just a minute.
Customer service is my priority.
Oh, hey, baby. How's it going?
Oh.
Baby?
Okay.
You whore of Babylon, Yasmin! Shame on you, you whores!
Yasmin, you've got to stop. You can't say whore in a bank. Stop. Please.
I'm sorry, that was my girlfriend. She called me from another bank. It turns out she went out on her lunch break and opened an account for me. I didn't have to come in here at all, so... Anyway, I'm just gonna get my ID and stuff and go.
Ooh, you're looking up close. A handsome fellow like you can go to any bank you want. What does her bank have? Higher interest rates?
I don't know.
Charismatic online presence?
I don't know, but I have to go back to work. I'm sorry.
Yes, me? The customers... Not love and trust.
I know. It's just that the line gets so blurry, you know?
No, I don't know.
Oh, thank God. It's 4:00. It's time to get out of here. Harry needs to lock up.
You did it again, Yasmin. You don't deserve love!
Yasmin, stop. Hey, Yasmin. Hey, look at me. You deserve love. You know, the funny thing about love is that sometimes it could be standing right next to you with an old broom.
Don't dare touch me! Nobody's ever gonna love you, Harry!
Yes, Bruce.
Noble gods of Mount Olympus, come to pay tribute. Where is Poseidon, god of the sea?
Here, Zeus.
And where is Pore, goddess of seasons?
Here, Zeus.
All are accounted for. How do you pay tribute?
No, excuse me, Zeus.
Yes?
You skip me. It is I, Climos, god of climate change.
Yeah, here's the thing. Don't totally believe that you're a god.
But I've been right in front of you for decades. I'm clearly a god.
Well, if you're a god of warming, how can I do this?
That blizzard? That's weather, not climate. See, I, Climos, rule over the statistical changes in weather patterns when those changes
are Take it easy, you can say before. Poseidon, for what do you pay tributes?
Zeus, you are a powerful and generous king. For first, you give me the vast oceans, and then you rapidly raise my sea levels!
No, hold on. That's my thing. I melted the Arctic shelf irreparably.
I don't think so!
Me neither.
Nor do I. See? There's no expert consensus.
Okay, I'll show you. Look. Ah! So, the red line indicates CO2 levels before I was born from your skull.
Call the nerd police! Loose nerd!
Huzzah, I'm nerd indeed. Oh, boy. Hooray, for what do you pay tribute?
Zeus, you're strong and fair. First you give me the seasons, and then you say, have a ball. And you let me have a 70-degree day in December for, like, oh, no reason at all.
No, my thing, again. You're all doing... Pay to me, not Zeus. I'm more powerful. Just look at the snow on these mountain peaks.
Nothing happened.
Give it 100 years.
But surely, if the world is warming, it's because of the sun, which is in the sky, and I rule the sky. Huzzah!
No. You let a bunch of holes get in the sky, and that increased my power. The ozone layer is a region of the stratosphere that absorbs sun from...
Nerd 1 and Nerd 2, come in.
Breaker, Nerd 2 here. We've established contact with the nerd.
Listen, nerd. I'm no scientist with a bunch of facts and figures. All I am is a hard-working goddess who supports the small businesses who pray to me.
Yeah! Don't preach to us, nerd!
Back to Athens with you, elitist!
We'll see eventually!
Alright. On to old business. Should we keep fracking Mount Olympus?
Absolutely.
Yes, definitely.
Traveled around and we were the Lenny Mudlow trio because somebody had a baby. That new mama in the house is the hot mama on drum, Summer Winters. Hi, I'm Piano, yours truly, Lenny Mudlow.
Yeah!
Folks say to me, Lenny, how many people does it take to make a quartet? Well, it takes four, baby. Francis Maple, Big Daddy Cowboy, and Lenny Mudlow.
Can I have a water up here, please?
A round of applause for your service this evening, Julia and Uruguay. Keep that round of applause going for the man doing the lights and the sound, Kenny Stone. And of course, we can't possibly forget Francis Bay, Big Daddy Calhoun, Summer Winters, Lenny Mudlow, and Aquafina.
six, a five, six, seven, before we actually get started. We just want to let you all know that we just got done recording our latest CD, which we're selling at the back of the bar. It's called Introductions. There's a little clip for you all. Play it, Kenny.
Francis Maple, Big Daddy Calhoun, Summer Winters, and yours truly, Lenny Mudlow. Yeah. Francis Maple.
Whole CD. Oh, well, we're going to take our intermission now. If you'd like to purchase a copy of the CD, please. But if you want a copy of the CD signed, we'll be in the alley out back smoking a joint. We're the coolest one-name bohemian in town. I'm talking, of course, about Gordites. yeah. You ready to go smoke?
Yeah!
We'll be right back.
When you delivered the eulogy?
I delivered a eulogy? Come on, it's not like you're any saint. You've been drinking all day.
Yeah. Mom would kill us if she found out we were drunk at her funeral.
Well, Mother wouldn't let us do a lot of things when she was alive. Hey, show me your wang.
What?
I don't know, I just haven't seen it since you were a kid. I mean, want to make sure I didn't turn that off.
I'm not going to show you my wang, Dad.
I'm just curious. I want to make sure everything turned out all right, Dad.
No, why? Because Mom's here to stop you from seeing my wang?
Damn straight. You think she'd be all right with that?
No. Dad, no.
What kind of world do we live in where a father can't see his own son's wang?
Like, this world. The world that we live in, Dad. I showed it to Mom like a month ago. It's fine.
Wait. You let your mother see your wang and not me?
There was just something happening. I just had to show it to someone medically.
And you went to your mother?
Dad, don't make it...
What does your mother know about wangs?
I don't know.
I know wangs! I have a wang!
Dad, I can't come to you with my wang problems.
Son. You can always come to me with your wang problems.
I guess I have to now.
Take a voice.
Wang problems.
Your mother would not be okay with this.
No, definitely not. Dad, can I ask you?
Sure.
Was Mom good in bed?
What kind of question is that?
I don't know. I'm curious.
Why do you want to know, anyways?
Because it's normal to think about your mom.
No,
like that.
No, it's not. Not at all.
Well, I couldn't ask when she was here and she's gone now.
She was horrible. She didn't know where to put her hands. She was always cold. She didn't like ruffling the sheets.
That sounds like Mom.
I know you're too young to understand this, Rory, but you give up a lot of things for love.
Yeah, that's sweet. Wish you said something like that during the eulogy.
Your mom was bad at sex?
Not that part.
What did I say anyway?
Mostly just complained about Obama.
And then it's so fucking spineless.
I know, I was there, Dad. I remember.
I don't know what I'm gonna do, Rory.
Yeah, me neither.
Baker boys.
Baker boys.
Totally clueless. Yeah, let's see that wang of yours.
Dad.
As soon as you show me your wang, as soon as we can all move on to our stinking lives.
Fine. Jesus Christ.
That's good.
Oh my God.
No, that's my dad.
My wife just died.
And we're gonna get fucking weird without mom.
Oh God, yes.
What about me, Dorothy? Do me!
Oh, you weren't in there one bit.
But I raised you.
Oh, but Toto, you were there.
The dog?
Yes. and the apple trees, and the poppy flowers. Oh, and remember when 8 years ago we went to the zoo and I saw monkeys? Why, they were there too! Oh, there's all so much. I feel dizzy.
Oh, perhaps you need a glass of water. I'll get you, Mom. I'll get you water. Just like I always have. For your entire life.
I just had to stop by and make sure that little lady was all right.
Why, you were in my dream, too!
Oh, was I?
Wait, who are you?
Just a drifter.
This random man, but not me?
Yes! Why, you were the wizard, and the carriage driver, and the gatekeeper, and the guard.
Jack of all trades, really.
Dorothy, don't you think I could have been any of those people in your dream?
But you weren't. Oh, and Miss Galt was there, too. She was a wicked old witch, but I don't know why.
Well, probably because she's trying to kill your dog.
Oh, I don't know.
No, she's definitely trying to kill your dog.
That's why.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know if we'll ever find out. But I do know that I threw water on her, and her skin melted as if it were acid. Why, I can still hear her screaming right now.
Probably gonna get back to drifting.
Yeah, I think we'd all better get away from you for a while. Yeah.
Oh, no, no, wait! Don't you understand? It's okay that you have no brain, and you have no heart, and you're a coward, and you, I feel nothing. Don't you see? I had to come back because I learned that you're all worthless without me.
Fuck you!
Throw her back into the tornado!
Yeah.
Okay, goodbye! Goodbye!